Why will Jesus Christ repeat feed my sheep three times? Why will he repeat feed my sheep, feed my sheep, feed my sheep three times with emphasis? Jesus Christ 2,000 years ago had seen in the year 2020 that there will be a time in the world that sheep will be eating dead grass. Christ has already seen the time is coming that there will not be good food around. The time is coming that the sheep will not have green grass again. The time is coming. Look at me. The shepherd will be so easy. It will be so lazy. I told you before how the fool are the sheep. Fool are you migrate from the north to the east. Fool are you will kill anybody in the far. Why? For the sheep that are in the local circle. They don't enter motor, they don't enter anything. On their leg, they will go out wide so that the sheep can feed. They know the importance of feeding a sheep. They don't care what it takes to feed a sheep. Christ was telling people, I am not telling you to feed the people. I am not telling you to feed human. Feed my sheep. Why? He was using the idiom. How a good shepherd should go after the sheep. Christ won't be able to know. Not welfare, they will eat lion. They don't get any clutch. I have seen a goat eating the paper before. Is that correct, man? I have seen a goat eating what is not grass. Why? Because there is no grass. They were eating what they are not supposed to eat. Christ knew 2,000 years ago that a time is coming. Once there is no shepherd that can take the pain, that can take the anguish of taking the sheep right inside where there is green grass, where there is no shepherd that can go far to bring green grass for the shepherd will suffer. And Christ came from the dead. He was dead. He remembered. I paraphrase again. Christ never forget anything. But he knew there is an urgent message. If these people should go on in this message, if the gospel of the Lord should prosper, if the gospel should be delivered very well, I have to tell these people one thing. Even though it came from the dead, he said, Peter, this urgent and important message, feed my sheep. What am I going at this church this morning? But as I go, if you want to be part of my kingdom, you are a shepherd already. Ensure that you feed my sheep. Church, I have a good news for you this morning. The same message that Christ brought from the grave to come and tell Peter, I am bringing it back to the church this morning. I am talking to you. You give me your life to Christ. Congratulations. You are in for this. Why? You are going to be part of this work. Christ knew that the time is coming that the word of God will be twisted. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, and every other thing shall be given unto you. It will tumble. Seek ye first every other thing, and the kingdom of God shall be given unto you. That is not a good food for a sheep. That one is poison. No sheep will eat that one, and the Lord is the question. Christ came and he told the disciple, feed my sheep. Brethren, this morning, year 2020, I am begging the church and also for all of us, this is an era we are in that the sheep are suffering. Brethren, there is a drought. When I say drought, what is another word for drought now? Drought, eh? Famine. There is a famine. Famine of the word of God. The word of God is no more. It is now the word of man. In provision, using the word of man as the word of God, putting first the interest of the pastor before the interest of God. God, Christ knew this will happen. He came to Peter what in your life. The interest of my sheep will be what we consider. Peter, feed my sheep. Why? Christ knew that when the sheep is hungry, the sheep gets fatter. A sheep that is looking for food goes everywhere. And today, brethren, the sheep Christ died for on the cross of Calvary, they are now hungry. The question is, where are the shepherds? And where is the green grass? You don't get it. I pray Holy Spirit will give you understanding now. Christ said, Peter, feed my sheep, feed my sheep, feed my sheep. My sheep, they need good food for them to have nutrients, for them to be robust, for them to be good, they need good food. Brethren, the Christian today, we need the good word of God to be productive. It is a tree, the quality of a tree that determines the quality of the fruit. The good word you get brings out the best from you. What am I trying to say? Today, the word of God, that pasture that the sheep needs to be, is as if it's not available anymore. What am I trying to say? Check out the quality of feed. Check out the quantity of grass that is being fed to churches today. Where did Jesus Christ teach the gospel of all this one that we are having in the world now? He came to tell Peter, what I fed you with, make sure that is what you feed my people. Don't feed them what I did not give. Brethren, there is a kind of food now that is being served to the church. It's dangerous. Why am I saying this? Why am I saying this? People are being casualty. I see people going from one place to the other. Do you know the Bible in the book of Ezekiel? If you get to read Ezekiel 23, you will see where God said, you shepherd, you destroy my sheep. You make my sheep to be going from everywhere. He said, I will destroy you, this shepherd. As I'm talking to you, the Bible is happening right before our face. The people are going from everywhere, looking for the truth. They want to serve the Lord. They want to hear God to tell them what to do. People want to make decisions. Before they want to hear God, before they make decisions, over their children, over their husband, over their business, they want to hear God. And they went to church. Pastor, this is my problem. The pastor led them, defend them wrongfully. Dangerous foods are now what people are eating. Brethren, Christ has seen this thing 2,000 years ago, and that was why Christ was shouting, feed my sheep, Peter. Number one, he repeated it. Number two, he repeated it. Number three, he repeated it. He came from the grave to come and remind Peter, feed my sheep. Hear me, church. Because you are listening to me, teaching, or you are here or outside. Tell the pastor, no man of God that feed the sheep of Christ will run from that will not be punished. The generations that will punish. If Christ came from the grave, if he came, he came among the living from the grave to come and tell Peter an urgent thing. What am I trying to say? He knew that thing is important. A time is coming now. Look at churches now. Many people now, it does not matter. Instead of them to tell people to forgo their sin, instead of them to tell them a sinner will never see the glory of God, instead of them to tell them wash your dirty linen and follow the Lord, instead of them to tell evil possessed sinner, they are telling them about how to make millions. They are telling them about how their grandmother is doing them. They are telling them about how their sister is doing them. They are deceiving our youth that for them to make money, this is what they will do. They are telling our youth that you have to go to village, you have to go and do this one. Every kind of evil message, that is not the food God said.